Hey guys, it is Tuesday the 21st of May now. I didn't vlog at all yesterday. I stayed up all night for Game of Thrones and had work at 10:30. By the time I got home, I was really tired. I only managed to read a little bit of the book I'm in the middle of reading, which is Dorothy Must Die. So yesterday was a little bit of a write-off. I didn't vlog at all yesterday, so I'm sorry about that. Not that you really care that much, I mean, let's be honest. I did get paid yesterday, so I spent a nice amount of money on books. I'm sorry, I'm sitting down for this one. I also got a ring light, yay! So now at least my videos will have a little bit more professionalism to them. I'd love to get a better camera, but literally I'm spending my money on everything else at the minute. I got a ring light, it was nice and cheap, but at least it will help these videos come across a bit more professional. Yeah, I'm trying it out right now. So this is the first time I'm using a ring light, and I think it looks pretty good so far, so that's good. And yeah, so reading update, we are on day two of the week and I am still reading Dorothy Must Die. I only really started it yesterday after Bingoathon last week, and I'm only on page 52. I really didn't manage to read a whole lot of it yesterday. I only read about like 10 pages at work. I was very sidetracked. But I'm enjoying this so far. Some of the writing does come across as a little juvenile. This is about a young girl called Amy, and she gets taken to Oz in a tornado. Amy's kind of what you would call trailer trash. Yeah, she comes to Oz. She knows all about Oz through, you know, the book and the movie. So she thinks that she's having a hallucination. She has arrived in Oz. It's devoid of colour. She doesn't know what's happened to it. And everybody she meets seems pretty scared. And every time Amy asks what happened here, people say Dorothy happened. And obviously we know Dorothy as, you know, as the main protagonist of The Wizard of Oz. She kills the Wicked Witch of the West and East, and she's seen as a good character, so what the fuck did Judy Garland do? I'm really interested to see how all this came about. So already, yep, I'm 52 pages in and not much has been revealed yet, but I'm enjoying it. I am enjoying it so far. So I'm off work today, so I'll try and read more today and tomorrow. I'm also off work, but I'm going to see Aladdin, and I did want to try and start the Aladdin book. So, I mean, this is 450 pages long, so I can't read 400 pages in one day, I'm sorry. I could give it a good go, I guess, but there is lots to do today, so yeah, this is my reading update, sorry. But yeah, Dorothy Must Die. But yeah, there isn't really much to update you with just yet. Yeah, yesterday was good, apart from Game of Thrones. I'll not speak much about Game of Thrones, but I will just say that I was extremely disappointed by the ending. I mean, saying that, like, some of the things I'm glad it ended that way. Like, I'm not going to go into any spoilers, but, like, parts of it I'm glad it ended that way, but it just didn't have the time to develop and get to that point. It just, it felt, I had major whiplash this season, and it genuinely needed more episodes. It really did. So yeah, that's all I'm saying on the matter. Other than that, I am feeling a lot better today on that subject, so I will check in tonight, see how much more of Dorothy Must Die I get read. Oh, I love this new ring light, it looks so good. Oh, I'm so happy. I'm so hot right now as well, gosh. Whew. So yeah, I just walked down to my barber's. I gave her a couple of books. She asked for recommendations for thrillers when I got my hair cut last week, and I told her, you know what, let me get them for you as a gift. And yeah, so I've just been down to give her them. She was over the moon. So yeah, I love giving books to people. It's my favorite thing. I didn't check in last night, I'm sorry, but it took me a while to get into reading last night. I was just really distracted. I think I only read up to, I'm on chapter 19, page 183 of Dorothy Must Die. I'm on my way into town to go see the new Aladdin, and I'll bring this along. I'll probably start reading it in Starbucks or something, and yeah, have a coffee and stuff. I haven't had a coffee yet, so I'm feeling a bit worse for wear. But I'm excited to keep reading. It's still been quite interesting so far. I do have minor issues, but the story can't really fault right now because it's making me keep wanting to read on. So yeah, hopefully I'll get quite a lot of reading done. I want to finish this today, I really do. So I've just got to stop being distracted. I'm too easily distracted. So I'll check in later, I'll tell you how the movie was. I will see how much I got read out in the wild. And yeah, see you then.
Well, pick me up, go. I got the times wrong. It starts at 10, not 11. So I missed the showing, but I'm going to a later one now, so. And I'm by myself, because my friends were at work. Well, I would like to hold my little hand. How about we run? How about cry?
Hello again. So I've just come back from seeing Aladdin and I absolutely loved it. Like, oh, I just loved it so much. It made me cry at the end. We all know that the genie gets freed because, you know, it's a bit of a 27-year-old spoiler. So same thing happens in this one. And I just cried. It was beautiful. There were so many great, beautiful moments in this one. Loved the music. It wasn't perfect. There were a lot of times where the music just didn't seamlessly go into the scene. So it felt a little jaunty at times. And the animated version is just, of course, amazing, incredible, spectacular. It came out the year I was born, the original. So that just held a little special place in my heart. But I really enjoyed the live action remake. It was incredible. I loved it. I know people had some gripes, one with Will Smith being the genie. Obviously nobody can beat Robin Williams at that role. Robin Williams really, really made the genie stand out. He was energetic, he was incredible. Will Smith isn't as lively as Robin Williams was, but it's really hard to explain, but he really does make the role his own. I think he did a great job. I'm not complaining about Will Smith. And another one as well, like in the clips of Woohoo! Get a bit more comfortable. And the second thing that people had a problem with as well was Jasmine in the clips. But when you see the entire film and you see Jasmine from start to finish, she is actually a great character. She is just as feisty as she was in the original animated classic, if not more so in this one. They really give her some great depth that I felt with the role, so I was really impressed. And she has this song called Speechless that's nyarish towards the end. In fact, I think there's two parts before that, but then she sings the song in full towards the end, and it is amazing. I love that song. It's powerful, it's great. God, I can't get comfortable, fucking hell. So yeah, I absolutely loved Aladdin, and Jasmine was amazing. Like, Aladdin was amazing. I thought they were all really good. I didn't really like Jafar that much. I think he was so much better in the animated version. He isn't as scary or intimidating or as iconic as he was in the animated version. But I warmed up to him more during the film, so all hope was not lost. There were some good changes as well. I quite liked a lot of the cinematic scenes. They did it really, really well, transferring it onto the screen. Some things were better than the animated version, some things weren't. I'm not going to exact detail because it only just came out today in cinemas. So I don't want to spoil anything for you guys. But I will say that I loved it. And I love the Disney live action remakes. So I love the Beauty and the Beast remake. Sue me. And yeah, I love the Cinderella one, the Jungle Book one. Dumbo was good. I enjoyed Dumbo for what it was. What's my favourite? Maleficent was alright. Alice in Wonderland, decent. But yeah, I think Beauty and the Beast and Aladdin at the minute are my two favourite Disney live action remakes. I just absolutely love them. And yeah, really worth seeing, really worth checking out, guys. I am absolutely melting.
I'm melting! Oh, what a world, what a world!
Speaking of melting, actually, read an update, Dorothy Must Die. I did give this a bit more of a read today. I'm on page 225. I wanted to read more while I was in Starbucks and stuff, but I just kept getting distracted. All I wanted to do was listen to the soundtrack of Aladdin again. So I honestly, I didn't really get a chance to read much of this. But I want to sit down, give this more of a read, because I want to try and finish it today. But I'm only halfway through, but I'll try. And then I want to start Aladdin, the book, tomorrow. So I really want to give this a read. It's the wrong way around. There we go. Aladdin. I really can't wait to read this now. I'm glad I waited to see the movie before I read this one. This is a novelization of the movie. Don't know what to expect. They can be pretty hit and miss sometimes. But I am excited. I am excited to give this one a read now. So I'm just dying to finish this one so I can start this one and hopefully finish it quickly, because I feel like I'm falling a bit behind this week. We're only on Wednesday, but I'm still only halfway through this, and it's getting, yeah, I want to finish this ASAP. I want to move on to the next thing now. Not that I'm not enjoying this, because I am, but I just want to get to the next thing. Like, I feel like I've spent too long reading this one. Too many distractions, man. There's just too much going on. Excuse me, I want to listen to the soundtrack one more time. Listen to that Speechless song, and yeah, then I'll get some reading done again. I also want to do a bit of a pamper day because I'm back at work tomorrow. I want to have a nice bath because it's been hot today. And just chill, you know, just chill and read. Hey, I've just had a lovely little bath there and I'm ready to settle down, do a bit more reading. So, haven't read anything more since the last update. Telling you, I've just been so super distracted this week. But before I settle down and read some more, I do want to put on a charcoal mask. I've had this since my birthday. I got it off my brother and his girlfriend, Shawnee, and it looks good. I've never had one before. I don't know what it'll be like. It's a detoxifying bubble mask. Leaves your skin feeling refreshed. I could do with that. Only supposed to leave it on for 15 minutes. So, yeah, thought I'd give it a whack. Put it on the old vlog, you know. Because that's what this vlog is about. How do I do it, though? That's the question. Oh, it feels really weird. Ew. Ew. What do I do with this? What the fuck? Ew. Oh, it feels proper slippy. So how do I do it? I must open it. Oh my god, that feels really rank. Oh, please don't drop it. Oh, hang on. There's an eye. Oh, what in the world? I feel like I'm on a timer here. Oh, I don't know how to fucking open this. Oh, hang on. Oh, I've made a bit more progress. Okay. Oh, okay. Okay, hang on. Oh, my. Oh, hang on. I've got an opening. Oh. Oh, okay. Right. Let's see. So then do I just whack it on? Wait, what's up with that mouth? Oh, wait. It goes this way. I was wondering what the hell was wrong with it there. Okay, so, let's go on. This side, there's a lot of bubble stuff on this. Oh, there's a lot of bubble stuff on both sides. Do I just literally stick it on? Hang on. Right, let's give it a try. Oh, that feels so weird. Oh my gosh, it's so weird. Oh, hello. What a stunner. I feel like I'm in a American Horror Story. Oh, yeah. Oh, I feel it. Can you feel it? Really, like, work it in there. Okay, there we go.
It isn't like one of those like charcoal ones that you see on people putting them off and then like rips off your face. But this is so weird. I don't even know what time it is, so I don't even know when 15 minutes will pass. But okay. I think I've done it right. If not, I'm a fucking mug. But let's see how it goes. I feel like I've had Botox, I can't even move my face, really. I think I look like Michael Myers now. Wow. Okay, it's been on for about 15 minutes now. It's really sliding down. I think it's going to go into my eyes. So I'm going to have to take this off. So be prepared to be amazed. Oh. I do hope I had it on the right way. Because that's like all fizzed up on the side that... This was the inside. Maybe it is right. Let's have a look. Oh my god, I look like somebody's just spunked all over my face. I should be so lucky. So this was a charcoal face mask review. Sponsored by Beauty Formulas. I'm going to go and wash this shit off now. And I'll give you a proper reading update later. Hey, it's Tuesday night, just after midnight, so technically Wednesday morning. And I have just finished reading Dorothy Must Die by Danielle Page. It was good. I would have given it 3 stars. I had a very hard time believing that... Okay, a little bit of spoilers in case you haven't read, but not really that spoilery. But, like, obviously you must know that Dorothy's an evil bitch in this one. And so is, like, the Scarecrow, the Tin Man and the Lion. But I didn't feel like it was developed well enough for me to believe that they had turned evil. Okay. How can I explain this? Like, in the original story, obviously, like, Dorothy, Scarecrow, the Tin Man and the Lion are the good guys, and I have a very hard time believing that they would turn this evil by the time this book comes about. Like, by the time Amy Gum, who is the protagonist in this one, comes about. And I just had a very hard time believing that they would turn this evil. I didn't feel like, I wasn't convinced by the backstory of this, like, that they would do what they've done. So that was a bit jarring for me. The Wizard of Oz is one of my all-time favourite movies. The book, The Wonderful Wizard of Oz by L. Frank Baum, was a book that I read so many times as a kid, and I love the original stories. I love Dorothy, and so it would have been a very hard ask for Danielle Page to make them evil and make them believable in that sense. But even then, like, the explanations in this were very lackluster. It just didn't seem organic. I did like the main character. I liked a couple of the developments. A lot of it was some of it was a bit boring. Like, it did kind of take a while to get going. I did end up liking the last couple of chapters because everything sort of picked up then. In the words of Jojo, you know, too little, too late. I am going to read the rest of them because I do want to see what comes next. But I'm just glad that I finished this book today. This came up on my Bookopoly. I think it was for the retelling. Yeah, I think this was for the reader retelling. Correct me if I'm wrong. No, I think it is. I think Dorothy Must Die is the retelling role that I made. Which means now I get to start Aladdin. Yay! So this one should be quite a fun and easy read. It is a novelization. It's about 280 pages long. And I just saw the film today as well. If you haven't skipped the vlog at this point, then you will know that I really enjoyed the film. I'm looking forward to seeing how this lives up to it in a way. Like, it probably is a bit pointless because I have just seen the movie, so I know what happens. I know all the story. But I still want to dive back into this world. I want to see what I think of it. Hopefully it'll only take me a day or two to read. I am at work tomorrow, so I will have to read some on my break and when I get home, so I probably won't finish it tomorrow. But as much as it looks like easy to read, I mean, just look at the sort of illustration of the book. It's that this I should fly through this.
I still have this and Gerald's Game to finish on my Mate ABR, and then that's all my bookopoly done. And I want to, and I still want to read Clash of Kings as well, so I'm going to try and fit that one in. But I think I'm going to head to bed now. It's been such a nice, chill day, you know, going to the cinema and, yeah, and just reading, really. And, you know, pampering myself a little bit as well. Yeah, my skin feels quite nice right now, so I'm quite happy. So I'm all pampered up, ready for bed. And, yeah, I will be up early in the morning for work. And it should be a good day. I will check in tomorrow. There is actually a spider on my bookshelf. This is very scary. And right above the Stephen King books as well. Like, it just knew. That is, oh my god, the shadows make it look even bigger. Oh no. No. Oh no, what am I going to do? Well, I'm too scared to go anywhere near it, aren't I? So it's going to have to stay exactly where it is. And I'll just have to sleep with one eye open tonight. I know how that little fucker got in as well. I leave my window open while I'm at work. And it must have just came in the window. But why does it have to make a home on my bookshelves? That's just fucking rude. That is just rude. I'm gonna have to leave it. I can't even go anywhere near enough to kill it, but I don't want to kill it. Because it's a poor little defenseless thing. And I'm scared for nothing. But, oh my god. Spiders just terrify me, so I'm just gonna let him be. Let him be. Fucking asshole. Anyway, reading update. I finished Aladdin. It's not... Wait, what day is it today, actually? Sorry, it's Wednesday. It's Friday now. Well, Thursday. Oh my god. Okay, it's Thursday night, but it's technically Friday. But it's not technically Friday until I've been asleep. So it's Thursday night. It's after midnight. And I finished reading Aladdin. This was a really quick, fun read. Give it 3 stars. It's good. I did enjoy the film yesterday. I thought that was a really good film. And yeah, it's pretty much a novelization of that movie, minus the songs, and I love the songs. So what I would do is, when I got up to those moments in the movie, or the moments in the book where in the movie they start singing, I would pause reading, get up my Spotify and put on the soundtrack, and it was great. It was a really fun time. I did only give it 3 stars rather than 4 because I think, yeah, the writing was very basic, and there were some moments where it added a little bit more depth, but I'm excited to go back into reading, you know, proper stuff now. And the next book I am reading is Gerald's Game, and this is the last book that I absolutely have to read for me, because I rolled horror on my Gabopoly, and I absolutely love the movie, and I think it's just such a great film, the way it was acted, it really creeped me out. If you haven't seen the Netflix movie, I would 100% recommend it. March, I read Pet Sematary before the movie came out in April. Book was better, and it's better than the original Pet Sematary movie that came out in the 80s as well. And then in April, I read Misery, and I love the Misery movie, but the Misery book was better again. So I really loved the Netflix movie of Gerald's Game, so I'm really hoping this one lives up to the other ones as well. I really hope I can read this one quickly so I can get started on A Clash of Kings. Yeah, that's pretty much all I've got for you guys tonight. I'm going to head to bed now. I've got work again tomorrow. It was supposed to be a day off, but I'm covering somebody who's off sick. I'm really excited to record a video tomorrow. And I know exactly what it's going to be. And I've been really excited to record it for some time now. Because I've had an idea for it. And you will see what that is. Oh, actually. This vlog will go up after the video's uploaded, I think. I hope. Yes, it will. So I will tell you what that video is. And that is the Ghibliathon. The Ghibliathon TBR. And I'm so excited to record that. Because I want to wear my Totoro onesie. And I just want to get all like snuggled up in my onesie and just, oh, I just can't wait to record another video. So and make you guys smile. Okay, that's all I have for you.
Alright, I'm gonna test this out. 1, 2, 3. Oh, is this cute on the wall? Can you see it though? Like. Oh. Oh my god.
So it's Saturday the 25th and it is 11 o'clock at night. I'm sorry I didn't vlog at all yesterday. I covered a shift at work. I didn't finish until 9 p.m. I didn't do any reading that day. I filmed my Ghibli-a-thon video when I got home. I really wanted to film it during the day, but because I had to cover that shift, it kind of threw my schedule out of whack. So I didn't read it anything. But today, I've, again, been at work, and I made very little progress on this. I am on chapter 3, page 39, and that's really bad for me. This month I've been reading about 150 pages a day on average. I think the most I've read was an entire book, which was that Aristotle and Dante. I read all that in one day, but these past couple of days, I've just barely been able to read. This week's been a bit of a slumpish week. I wouldn't say I'm in a reading slump, but I just haven't been as actively reading as I would like. So I'm going to read more of this tomorrow. I'm off work. I want to try and get as much of it read as I possibly can. It is my last read for May. So wish me luck. I am very tired, so I'm going to go to bed. Otherwise, I would read more. This is actually very early for me to go to bed. 11 p.m. Like, what? But I'm just so tired. I was up until 4 a.m. last night. I finished my Ghibli-a-thon video like at midnight. But sometimes I get bad anxiety when I go to bed, and I just think of things, and it keeps me awake. And I hope that doesn't happen again tonight. It usually does. Like, I'm so tired I could fall asleep, but I know as soon as I turn the lights off and I put my head in that pillow, my brain, my mind is just not going to shut up, and it'll keep me awake. So I'm hoping I shut up tonight and I will get some sleep straight away. Good morning. It is the last day of the vlog, and yeah, it's Sunday, like 10 a.m. I've got my coffee. I'm ready to start reading ASAP because I'm worried I won't get all the books read that I want read by the end of the month. And I'm sorry, I'll sound a lot better after I've had a coffee. It's really dark and horrible outside, so I'm in my dressing gown, in my pajamas. Today's going to be a pajama day, back at work tomorrow, so I really want to get another video shot today. Just when I'm thinking of my schedule for next week, I want to try and fit in as much as I possibly can. So yeah, I think I might end up filming something else today, so I might not get as much reading done as I possibly could.
Hey guys, welcome back. If you're new here, my name is Becca, and today I am bringing you an enormous book haul. So this is.
I have just filmed my June TBR, and these are all the books that I now have to read. In 1 month. Plus one more. Be sure to tune into my June TBR video that should be coming up by the time I post this vlog, to find out what it is I have to read, to find out what all this shit is. I'm trying to read, but I keep getting reminded of song lyrics, such as, William was able to do much more than paddle in the shallows, and I just immediately burst out, oh, in the shallows. And I can't stop doing it, it's taking me ages to read. Just hold on and on and on and on and on. Hey guys, so it is Sunday night now, which means it's the end of the vlog, and you don't know how happy I am that I don't have to stay up tonight to watch an episode of Game of Thrones. Like, I can finally go to sleep at a normal-ish time because I do have work in the morning, and it is nearly 1 o'clock in the morning now, I think, and I have been reading. Well, I mean, firstly today I woke up, I read a little bit, I watched some television, I filmed my June TBR, and it is crazy. It is really fucking crazy. I have 15 books on my TBR, and I counted all the page numbers as well, and it is 5,364 pages for all the books in June. 5,364 pages. Then for Ghibliathon alone, which is running for 1 week, it's 1,788 pages, which is an average of 255 pages per day in that week. Yeah, I'm fucked. Reading wise, I have been reading Stephen King's Gerald Game today. I am on page 227, so I am only just half, well, I'm just over halfway through the book, so I really want to get this finished tomorrow, Monday. Let's pray for Gav. I am in awe of his writing style, like, seriously. Oh, he's just so good. Yeah, that is my reading update of the day. I think if I didn't record video today, I probably would have at least been nearly finished this. And I have been distracted with YouTube and things. So if, yeah, so I do have a distraction problem. So final wrap up of the week. I read Dorothy Must Die by Danielle Page, gave that 3 stars. Then I read Aladdin by Elizabeth Sudrick, I think. I don't have the book on hand at me at the minute. It's on the shelf and I can't be bothered to get up right now. And that is the novelization of the movie. I gave that 3 stars. And I haven't finished Gerald's Game yet. So last week I read 3 books in the 1 week. This week I've only managed to finish 2 and get halfway through my 3rd. So it wasn't the bestest of weeks, reading wise. And 2 of them have been 3 stars as well. This one is feeling like a 4 to a 5 star, maybe 4.5 star, but Goodreads doesn't do half stars, so it might be another 5-star Stephen King read. That's pretty much it. I may be uploading 3 videos next week. My vlog, my June TBR, and 1 other video. So stay tuned for those. I'm really excited to get those ones out. I just farted. I'm going to try and get this finished and A Clash of Kings finished next week. And with June starting on the Saturday, I'll have to start my June TBR reads. Fun, looking forward to the weekend. Thank you so much for watching if you made it all the way through. I really appreciate it. Hit me with one of these, you know what to do, if you like, and leave a little comment if you had a favorite moment, which you probably don't because it's been a boring week for me. Okay, good night. Bye.